Today's experiment is sponsored by HelloFresh.
Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Not too long ago, we tried an experiment to see what would happen if we poured molten salt onto dry ice. Well, we've got another experiment in the same vein today. We're gonna see if we can cook a steak with salt. And I don't mean we're gonna cook a steak that has salt on it. I mean we're gonna see if we can use molten salt as the heat source to cook a steak. Fans of the YouTube channel Backyard Scientist may remember a time when he tried to cook a steak using molten aluminum. And it sort of worked, but you couldn't really eat the steak because it had a lot of molten aluminum stuck to the meat. Well, hopefully, if our salt does stick to the meat, it will still be edible because it's salt. So we're gonna give this a try. We're gonna take some of our salt, we're gonna melt it down to a liquid in our crucible, and then we're gonna pour that onto our steak. We might try pouring it onto one side, and we might try pouring the salt into the pan, and then putting the steak on top of some of that salt for the other side. We'll see, it's just kind of gonna be a little bit of an adventure. So let's fire up the furnace, melt some salt, and see if we can cook our dinner.
This coarser salt is really good for putting on a steak when you're cooking in a normal method, but of course it's gonna melt down into a liquid. I don't know if it's gonna make much difference. We'll find out.
Our salt has melted down to a liquid and our steak is in the pan ready to go. I've put this jacket on because there is moisture on the surface of the steak and there's a chance that it could cause the molten salt to splatter up into the air and I don't want to get that on me. There's not so much moisture that I think there's any risk of a large steam explosion, but I do want to protect myself a little bit. That's why I've got the glasses and the long sleeves and of course the gloves. Whew, that is hot. All right, I'm gonna try and start pouring on one end and move down to the other end. We'll see how this goes. Oh, that smells so good. Oh my goodness. Wow, that is a fantastic looking crust on there. So our salt, as you can see, has definitely solidified. It did that pretty much as soon as it hit the pan. And we probably could have avoided that by heating up the pan, but I feel like that would be cheating. Then we'd be cooking our steak with a hot pan instead of with molten salt. However, even though it has solidified, it is still holding a lot of heat. This kind of salt melts at just below 1500 degrees Fahrenheit, which means that even though it's cooled down to the temperature where it's solid again, it's still very hot. So it's cooking our steak pretty well. At least on the outside. We'll have to see how it's doing on the inside. All right, here's our steak cooked on salt, cooked on molten salt. We first poured molten salt on top of it. Mostly it just ran off the sides. It landed in the pan, and then we cooked the steak on the molten salt in the pan. The outside has got a pretty good sear on it. We've got some good dryness. We've got some, the Maillard effect has started giving us some nice crispy outside places, but I do suspect that the inside of this steak is going to be pretty much raw. Let's cut it open and find out if I'm right. Oh yeah. So we can see that it did get cooked for about an eighth of an inch of the way through, and then the inside is still, oh boy, I think even calling this blue rare would be generous. It's, let's see, it's cool. It's not even a little bit warm. So if you like your steak ultra blue rare, I mean, this thing is still mooing, I'm pretty sure. I think a good vet could bring this back. It wouldn't be too late. I personally am not a big fan of super rare steaks, and I know all you steak enthusiasts out there are gonna be mad at me for that. I'm more of a medium, maybe medium rare kind of guy, but this is a little too much for me. Ultra blue rare. I will still take a small bite of it. It's the texture really that I can't handle. It's just slimy at this point. But I'll cut a piece off. Mostly I just want to see if it got some good salt flavor by being cooked on salt. I didn't salt the steak except for cooking it on the salt, so if I can taste any salt at all, we know where it came from. A little. There's a little bit of salt flavor to it. Not a lot. It's a good steak.
cooked properly, that would be fantastic.
Turns out pouring molten hot minerals, salt is a mineral, which means that what we made is sort of like lava, kind of. So yeah, pouring molten hot minerals on top of a steak is not the ideal way to cook it, but I do have another thing that I want to try.
But first, let's learn about our sponsor. If you like to cook at home, HelloFresh is a great way to do it. They've really set up a system that's convenient to use. If you have a busy schedule, you can choose the delivery day that works best for you. If you're going to be out of town, you can pause your account for weeks at a time. All of the ingredients come pre-measured in handy labeled meal kits, so you know which ingredients go with which recipe, unlike at a grocery store. And of course, the whole kit is delivered right to your door in recyclable, insulated packaging. HelloFresh offers a wide variety of chef-curated recipes that are different every week. They have the classic, veggie, and family plans to choose from. The recipes are designed to only take about 30 minutes to prep, so you're not gonna have to spend all night in the kitchen cooking. Several of the meals are designed to be one-pot recipes for speedy cooking and minimal cleanup. Each week, one meal in the classic menu is designed to only take 20 minutes to prep. I thought the instructions were easy to follow, prep time was quick, and the quality of the food was excellent. It's a really convenient and easy service to use, knowing that you're getting full meals in just the right portion sizes. For $30 off your first week of HelloFresh, visit HelloFresh.com and enter promo code KingOfRandom30. Now, let's get back to the steak.
Before we started melting the salt for this steak, we actually took a second steak and put it in what's called a sous vide cooker. That's a device that keeps a bath of water at an extremely precise temperature. So right now I've got some steak cooking in a bath of water at about 134 degrees Fahrenheit, which is a good temperature to get a nice medium rare cook all the way through. It's in a plastic bag which keeps it from being in contact with the water directly, but it still gets all of the heat. And since the water is being held at a very precise temperature, the steak will cook all the way through at exactly that temperature without overcooking anywhere. So now let's take our sous vide cooked steak out and let's put that into the pan and try the same thing with that and see if we can use salt instead of for cooking the steak all the way through, just to finish up the outside of it.
All right, there we go. Our steak is now cooked all the way through at just the perfect temperature. However, being heated by water doesn't really give us a nice outside look to our steak. And that's why we want to cook the outside with our molten salt. Mmm, yum. Holy cow. That is some very hot salt. Good. That is a delicious looking ribeye right there. All right. Let's see how this looks on the inside. Still got a little bit of pink. I'll admit that even though I don't like it rare, this is probably a little overcooked for me. A little bit more pink on the inside is more of what I look for. But that still looks pretty delicious. Try this again, see if it's got any salt flavor to it. The last one didn't have much. We'll see if this is any different. Not a lot, but this is a really good steak. Like I said, I really enjoy it when the texture has changed, which is why I don't prefer my steaks rare. This, the texture has definitely changed, and it did get cooked a little bit more than I wanted, so I probably had my sous vide machine set a few degrees too high. Even though I cooked this with salt, none of it really stuck to the steak, so I'm going to add a little bit more salt, and this is gonna be my dinner. Cooking a steak using molten salt. It does get a pretty nice sear on the outside, especially if you take care to flip the steak down in the salt as it's cooling in the pan. It doesn't really do a whole lot of searing as you pour it on. It just sort of skitters across. I think we have the Leidenfrost effect making the salt not really stick to or touch the steak very much.
Overall, if we pre-cook the inside of the steak and then use the salt as a sear on the outside, it does work, although it's a bit of a roundabout way of doing it. It would be easier to just sear it in a pan or on a grill or something like that. Or maybe just sear it directly in the foundry. If you've got some cool ideas of other things you want to see us try using molten salt, let us know down in the comments below. If we use your idea, we'll send you 25 bucks. Thanks again to our sponsor for this video, HelloFresh. Check the link in the description below for a discount off of your first order.